What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Daily here, Nation Fusion, and today we are revisiting one of probably one of my most viewed videos, and I'm not exactly sure why, but I definitely appreciate all the views on Call to Arms. My review of that at the time got an 8 out of 10. It is an interesting take on the third-person strategies genre, and I really do like the game, and it has only gotten better. So where my original review of the kind of beta state of the game got an 8 out of 10, I'd have to say, as we look at it now, this is more of a 9. This is a unique experience, but it's not without its flaws, so let's talk about it. So originally, the game launched into this kind of early access, and there was a lot of kind of interesting features, and there was just a little bit of kind of like clunkiness to it, and I'm sorry to say that the clunkiness is still kind of there. So overall, the experience is fun, but if you're expecting like a really smooth kind of fluid type of gameplay, it's tough to get. I have a feeling that those of you who play this game that are actually good at it can probably smooth it out a little better than I can, but I'm looking at this as kind of like the base, like general gamer. And so what we have is a third person real-time strategy game with a first person element to it, and you're going to see some clips of that. It has made leaps and bounds since the original uploading of that original review, and I have to say, like I said previous, it's only gotten better. So there are better textures, the FPS is much better, there's a destruction, there's a bunch of like interesting elements that go into this game. And I gotta say, looking at the campaign side of it first, one of the things that stood out to me is now that the campaign is kind of fleshed out, you have an American campaign that you can play through, and that has a bunch of different elements from it, and they kind of go with this like classic like action storyline, and but it's varied from mission to mission, and I kind of do like the theme, the vibe, even if it's not like the most fluid type of gameplay. A lot of like Men of War, Assault Squad kind of vibes here, but what you're able to do is play these kind of large scale engagements between yourself and an enemy faction, and you can press a button to actually take control of specific soldiers and use their weapons. So at times you'll see me like take control of a machine gunner or take control of a guy with an AT4, and what that can really do is like turn the tide of like a really overwhelming battle. So a lot of times in the, at least in the American campaign, you're fighting kind of like this insurgency force, and they have tons of enemies to throw at you, but they're not super well equipped and they're not super smart. So what you can do is you can set up kind of like a baseline defense and then take control of a character that you really want to play as and kind of like turn the tide of the battle. For instance, one of the second missions I believe I played, I had to assault this compound, and while I was assaulting the compound with my troops, these two enemy BTRs came, these like infantry fighting vehicles, and they pull up on scene and they're just decimating my guys. They killed both of my MATVs that I had, and I was able to take control of a lone AT4 soldier, do a flanking maneuver while the vehicles were kind of focused on my guys, and I used that AT4 to destroy the vehicles. And you know, it felt very satisfying to be able to do that, from move from cover to cover, and there's, you know, like a healing mechanic, so you know, your guys don't instantly just die. Sometimes they do, but a lot of times they go into this like bleed out state, and you can like bring in a Humvee full of guys to, you know, revive, or do, you know, a security force while you bring in a Blackhawk that drops medics. And it's like, it creates this awesome kind of like war vibe that you don't get from a ton of other games. They lose like their grandness in like the strategy aspect. So like a game like War Game, for example, that's like very like top-down commander-ish. You're not worried about the individual troop. There's not really much you can do in that kind of aspect. However, here you can, you know, get that vibe of like a full-scale like assault or full-scale war, and then you can zoom right down to the action and care about the individual soldier and his ammo count, and like, do we need to bring this platoon back to resupply? And I really did enjoy kind of that aspect, you know, of it. And then there's a lot of like different choices. So when we went into the skirmish mode, the AI is just way better than me, like especially since I haven't played this game in quite some time. So I got destroyed in the skirmish mode. But what I kind of like understood is, as you kind of gain points, you spend points to bring in new units, and you use those units to secure the sectors, at least in the domination mode that I was playing. And what happened was, eventually I had like a force where like I was having a supply truck bring troops back and forth, so when they spawn they didn't have to walk all the way to the city, and I kind of had like a supply line going right there. And then I had a fight over on the, you know, far side of the city, and I needed to scroll over, and when I scrolled over I was able to take control of one of my special forces guys, and he had like a long range scope, and I was able to take out a ton of these like enemy forces. And it really just kind of like shows the diverse nature that Call to Arms really has implemented. Now, I believe this game has made a couple of missteps in its execution as far as like getting out of early access and its plan to kind of do more, you know, things in its space. They have some DLC, which I feel like, especially with as unpolished as some of the mechanics can be, I feel like the price is just a bit too much. Currently, the game is $14.99. I believe this title to be like a $9.99, a $12.99, $14 is pushing it, but you know, if a couple of dollars makes or breaks you, that's, you know, going to be dependent on what you think of the gameplay. And they have a deluxe edition, which is $19.99, and then an ultimate edition, which includes a season pass for $30, and then they have like a complete bundle, which is $75, and then they recently had a Call to Arms Gates of Osfront, or Gates of Hell Osfront. That is a DLC pack, and that is $31. So there's quite a bit of like DLC and like package upgrades, and I really think that, you know, while this game is fairly good, it's tough to ask that kind of price when there's just a lot of like janky animations, and you know, it's easy to lose their cursor. It's like very tiny, even at you know, I'm playing at 4K, or excuse me, 1440p, so I believe 2K. It's easy to lose like the cursor, and like some of the missions where you have to play as like a sniper, the shots are not like one hit kills like you would expect from, you know, a 50 cal sniper rifle or even one of the high calibers. And you know, it's tough to complete like some of these missions. Just the difficulty scaling isn't super great for new players. There's a lot of like issues with different weapon swaps and things like that. Some of the animations get stuck. So this game is definitely not without its flaws, but I definitely think it moved, you know, in the right direction from our original video. And I definitely highly recommend this game. It, even with its flaws, it's just a fun and interesting take on the strategy genre. And with the amount of like weapons and vehicles and, you know, different abilities to replay like the campaign or create your own missions or play these you know, skirmishes online, there's just a lot of good stuff that the guys over at Digital Mindsoft did. So hats off to those guys. Again, this is a kind of follow-up to our original Call to Arms review. Let me know in the comment section down below if you guys are still playing this, if this is a game that it's on your wish list. What do you think of the first and third person aspects, and do you think that it, you know, can work in other games? Would you like to see this more often, or should it just kind of stick to one or the other? I'd be interested to hear your guys' thoughts. Thank you so much for watching. Be sure to hit that subscribe button if you already haven't done that. I would highly appreciate that. And thank you guys so much for all the love on the original Call to Arms video. I hope this has been a good follow-up to show you guys the kind of path that Call to Arms has taken. We'll see you next time here on Nation Fusion TV.